Hey guys, welcome back to TomZane.us. Today we're doing this quest called The Lost Lighthouse, and I'm here with my very sweet guildies, and they're gonna introduce themselves.
What's up,
Hi.
Igor?
How about that? I'm the Dark Vamp.
My name's Tsunami. I'm a 61 marksman.
I'm Lady Lightlust, and I'm a 38 vampire.
Nice, nice.
I'm Ice, 52 priest.
Nagor, 51 fire mage.
Yeah, they're all gonna keep us alive, so. Alright, so let's go into this instance, and I believe this instance is also, what is it, level 30 instance?
Yep, it's a level 30 gear instance.
Well, you guys probably already know, those of you who watch my channel, I'm totally noob at this, so I'm probably gonna just make a few commentaries and let my guildies take over. It's actually my second or third time coming to this instance, so hopefully we all have a good time and get some equipment. And I think, correct me if I'm wrong, our first boss would be that shark-looking guy, is that correct?
Yeah, the shark-looking guy is going to be the first boss. He has a frontal AoE, so the tank is usually going to want to turn him.
Nice. And just a quick commentary, guys. You guys probably already know that I've been kicked out of several guilds because they're like, oh, this guy, he won't join our chat or something. So finally, I'm with a new guild called Obscene, and I think you guys can sort of tell why the name it is. But we're gonna keep it PG at least for this session. So anyways, let's see what's going on here.
If anyone has the quest, can you grab them now?
Screw you on your freaking quest, Bukage.
You can't say my name.
But anyways, yeah, so, you know, if you guys are looking for a level 4 guild, I believe, we are a level 4 guild. We play here on PvP East USA, and that's called Ierda, I think. I always have trouble pronouncing that name. But anyways, I'm a level 35 knight, and I'm with this guild called Obscene. And so if you guys need an invite, let me know, or any of my fellow guildies know, and we'll be happy to recruit you into our guild. And looks like we are coming over to find Shark. So, any tips for our YouTube viewers on how to kill this guy really easy?
Usually you're gonna have a 30s group, and you're gonna have, you know, your protector and your priest. The protector is gonna want to turn it and taunt it. While all the DPS and the healers stay behind his frontal AoE.
Nice. Oh, speaking of that, my pet is dying.
You need to put pots on him.
Yeah.
So you have a lot of pots.
Yeah, I actually I ran out of pots. I actually have just a few for myself. I have about 18 of it. Yeah, finally got Alchemy 3 too. Took me a while to get Alchemy 3.
Don't feel bad. It wasn't until last week that someone actually explained to me how to do alchemy.
Nice.
My role.
Any event? Oh, crap.
Nice one, Hal.
Sadly, that's better than my gear I'm wearing right now.
Okay, there's a way that everyone goes and a way that you're supposed to go. Or yeah. The way everyone goes, because you're never going to find a group that goes the path you're supposed to.
Okay. Now,
just follow along.
Is there like a little shortcut? Because I heard there is.
Right, it's not a glitch or anything. We're just going to hop up on a rock over here to lose aggro on the mobs.
Also, just to some of our viewers who are not quite familiar with Forsaken World, it is a F2P. That means it's a free-to-play. And what that means is you can play as long as you want. The way you might ask, how are they going to make money off of it? Well, they make money by charging you. Well, not charging you, but you have the option to actually go to a cash shop and get some of the gears. Or maybe not gears. Some of the upgrade gems, you know, things that make you more advantage in terms of, you know, other players, you can do that for real life cash, and that's how they make money.
Okay, it looks like Lady Bloodlust got stuck behind the glitch here, so you're gonna have to pour it out and then come back in.
Okay.
Oh no.
That's right, it's a really quick run. She'll be right back.
What happened?
She fell down that hole.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Right behind these rocks here, there's a little ditch that you don't want to get caught in.
Do you know your way back here?
Oh yeah, I've been in here a couple times.
Cool.
The NPC to get back in the entrance manually is right down by Matthew the teleporter.
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna do one of the side quests now. After Lady comes back into the instance, it's gonna be finding Carol. She's just an NPC off to the left over here that we don't usually pass.
And you're saying that's a side quest?
It's a quest that you can pick up once you get into the instance. Most runs won't do it. They try to get to the end as fast as possible. We're gonna go and head that way.
Nice. But hey, you know, while we're waiting, you were mentioning earlier about a campfire or something like that. You want to tell us more about that?
Yeah, sure. Obscene has their campfire every night at 10:30, 2230 server time. It's not free, but we're all there. It's right in Tower Push Trackstone.
And when you
it's free experience.
Okay. And when you say it's not free, what does that mean?
There is an entrance fee for guests. It's only 4 silver. You can come in and enjoy a half hour of continuous experience.
Yeah, that's not bad. I had to pay like 8 silver or something earlier today for Noble Sea's campfire or something like that.
Not a very nice guild though. They usually PK members for no reason.
Yeah, I was just about to say that actually.
And look. Yeah, the nice thing about a campfire.
Who's on World Chat? Who is D-Bag?
He's one of our vice leaders. We don't have any regular guild leader. We just have 4 vice leaders that run everything.
Nice. And I think we also have a website, is that right?
We have a website right now, it's just obscenegaming.com. It's under construction and it'll be up by next week.
Nice. Well, since we're all waiting, I'm just gonna check out everybody's gears and show it off on the video and see who's got the best gear. It looks like Tsunami's got some really nice gears.
Yeah, nice offhand. I'm not gonna gear out until endgame, but you can see the durability on my my weapon there is pretty much shot due to massive PvP.
Wow, all of your gears are like 5 stars, dude.
I can take a look at my level 50 carnival weapon. It's a skunk.
So what's the trick in getting those ribbon stars on your gear?
The star is just a quality rating. All of your instance set gear, like level 50, is going to have the same amount of stars. You're better off looking at the stats and the identified stats more than the stars for quality.
And the chroma too, doesn't it? Like a chroma number determines whether it's going to shine or not.
Alright, so I'm going to pull out my sniper's angel again here.
And, Kiss, can I get a res, please?
She just PM'd me. She'll be right back and then she can res her. So I have 2 level 3 gems in my weapon, which makes it glow purple.
Alright guys, since we're waiting for Lady Bloodless, we're going to take a short break and we'll be right back.
I'm just potting to get my mana back.
Alright, cool. So guys, welcome back. Lady Bloodless is with us again, and we will continue where we left off. Alright, let's go.
Okay, we're gonna run down to Carol, the NPC, for the quest.
So I'm just curious, Tsunami, why are you luring all of these aggros?
I'm just about to AoE them.
Okay. And AoE is what, area of effect?
Effect. Correct. Also, the mobs here do not hit me. So I can aggro them all. I don't take any damage.
Nice. So by just running around, get the aggro, it's easier for you to kill in one shot.
You're right.
It's like shooting down a whole sky of birds with one stone.
So anyone who needs to complete the quest can just go talk to Carol over there.
Yeah, I gotta talk to her real quick.
All right, everybody good?
Yep.
Tsunami, you're such a hack.
My nightshade could get him down in 4 shots.
How do you get your skin like that?
My what?
Your dwarf skin is like deep blue.
Yeah, it was just one of the color options that we were about to choose.
Okay. It looked kind of creepy. Well, maybe not creepy, more like a scarish type of thing. Because you never see a dwarf or any sort of race with that color.
Creepy works.
I am the best looking marksman, right?
But maybe one of the best, not best looking.
Yep. Hey, where'd you guys go?
Oh, we're running north of the cave. I'll come back
there. I'm running back here, Tsunami.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, there's only like two or three mobs in here, so we just run right through.
Just come running through.
It's easier to kill them when we have all grouped up.
Go ahead and run on through them.
So what's this soul gem used for?
Soul gem level 1 is required to make green level 30 offhands.
Oh yeah, I remember I had to use that for my artisanship job.
Yeah. The soul crystals are required to make the blue offhands. We're gonna pull the mobs over here to the left, top to the NPCs.
First time I've seen that. I accidentally ended up talking to one of the NPCs by mistake and said, "Nice to meet you, lovely vampire."
Which NPC was that?
That was Paul.
Oh, I see.
It was kind of a mistake. I kind of clicked on it.
Was there a quest with him?
No. Well, okay. If there was, I don't remember. Like I said, I've been in here a couple times.
Cool.
And this is the only place you can get Flaming Lotus, the map. And that's used to make basic combat supplement potions.
And don't you need like a really high level in botany job skill for to even pick that?
I believe you need about 3. You need level 3 alchemy to make the potion.
And what kind of potion is it for?
It's called a basic combatant supplement, and increases your attack by 105%.
Oh, wow. That's kind of like me making physical mastery potion.
Correct.
Is that boss number 2 up there?
Yes, it is.
And you want to be careful with him.
Wow, he's ugly.
Can I get my mat out and get some food real quick? This boss has a blade reversal, which is a reflect. So any damage you deal on it, you'll get it right back to yourself. And so anytime that the reflect is on, we're not going to hit him.
And how do you know if it's on?
In normal chat, you'll see blade rebound, the NPC will say it. And in his debuff, topped by his HP, you'll see a little flame. And if you hover it over, it says, blade rebound.
All right.
Considering you're buffed already.
Reflect. DPS.
Hey, thanks for the heal. I don't know who's healing me, but thanks.
No problem.
Reflect.
Yeah, I was the same.
DPS.
That's our wonderful insect-y kid. Oh, I call her Kisses, but
hey, DPS.
Nothing I can use there.
This instance has a chance to drop a purple level or purple level 40 weapon, so maybe we'll be lucky.
And purple, is that better than blue?
Correct, it's epic gear.
Okay, weapon I just got, it's level 30 and it's blue. Is that better than what I currently have on?
That's a good weapon, yeah, probably. It's got 6% crit defense.
It's better. Just hopefully your attributes identify out, to be something useful. If it gets like mana or something, I would stick with your green one.
Okay, we're gonna go to Cave Boss, so we're gonna go up the hill back here.
Hey, thanks for getting the artillery. It actually gave me 6,000 XP. I think I had a quest to destroy it. And speaking of XP, I forgot to do God's Trial today.
It stacks three times.
Nice. Yeah, for those of you who are wondering what God's Trial is, it's basically one of the most popular way to gain experience in this game. It's a daily event, and you can participate, I believe, up to three. As a Tsunami mentioned, it's stackable, so if you miss one day, it's no problem. You can, stack it up. You can miss up to two or three days, and you can do it. All three of them on a single day, and it's a lot of experience. You know, I gained, well, you know, I started, I think, what, level 20, and progressing now into 35, and correct me if I'm wrong, I believe also the level 60s do it as well. Is that correct?
Yes, every level does it.
The experience scales up along the with your level.
Right, and also, don't forget to, what is that scroll called? The Lionheart scroll? doubles
yeah.
The XP? Yeah, don't forget that, because that's critical.
We need to hold here and wait for the other rest of the party to come.
Yeah, we're just going to kill the mobs outside of the cave.
Thank you.
I love that AoE Nagor.
I know I do too.
You're doing better than normal, must be because you're high on life.
Where'd Lady go?
Okay.
I thought you were behind me. That's what I was waiting for.
I was, but then I stopped for Tsunami and the others.
Oh, they're already up here.
Then yeah. I've got some serious... Oh my god, I have some serious glitching going on.
It always does that.
Yeah, this instance does that a lot.
Because I was standing back by what I thought was you, Tsunami.
Yeah, I had steroids back there, Nag, and Tsunami.
Wait, what happened?
A lot of times in this instance, if you get separated from the group, it'll lag out and it'll appear as if everyone is standing around you. When they're already way ahead of you.
Wow.
Well, it's not just this game or this instance. I get a lot of that too when I play Perfect World.
Sure, sure. And you know, speaking of glitches, you know, I had a few in this game, but so far it's been good. I must say that, you know, sometimes when I run around the main square on the Freedom Harbor, I get crashes, and that's not pleasant. And hopefully, if you're a developer for Perfect World, if you're watching this, please do look into it. We would really appreciate it.
Fix it! Just don't look into it. Fix it!
Hey, they're probably going to look into it. Because, you know, if not, I'll be like speaking to them in Chinese.
That'll get their attention.
I should start a channel teaching people how to speak Mandarin.
I think I'd rather learn Spanish first, just because of where I am and what I do in real life.
Yeah, Spanish, you know, predominantly in North America, it's pretty useful, but, I was actually quite surprised to read about this, but statistics has it Chinese Mandarin is the most spoken language in the world, and I think that's partly due to the population. And English is number two, but English is number one in terms of the most widely spoken. But anyways, let's get back to speaking Forsaken World, and so which boss are we at now?
The cave boss is just a bonus boss that most parties don't actually run. You just kill him for gear.
Is there a map for this instance? Oh yeah, there is. So you guys have any quick tips for, any guys or girls want to get a quick start in this game?
Get a good guild, because if you've got a good guild that's willing to help you out, you go a long way.
Yeah, what about you, Tsunami?
Stay in the Z zone, Armin. kill you. It's a PvP server. Don't cry. If you die, you can get over it. It's my biggest tip.
But that's
and you're safe from PvP until 30.
Yeah, that's a good point. The PvP starts at level 30.
Try not to make too many enemies when you're low level, because in the end, they can turn around and just hunt you down when they get higher level. You'll never know. People can hold grudges for a long time.
Like me.
And you can hit 30 in about a day and a half if you play it right.
Hey, that's what I did. I got level 30 in 2 days.
I think when y'all brought me to guild, I was 25 or 28, something like that. And once I was showed the ropes, y'all had me leveling pretty quick. I've been on about two weeks.
The nice thing about this game is the leveling is event-based, so you can get most of your experience in one day, like in a couple of hours of the day, and then you have the rest of the day to craft and do other things. It's not a grind fest like a lot of other games.
Yeah, I really like the daily quests, especially the Henry quest and the Rio quests, and of course God Trial. Those really help a lot.
They're like essential if you want to level.
But the downside is upgrading is so expensive.
Waste your money since leveling is so quick. And PvE in this game is fucking frigging easy. Complete the one. I won't say anything else.
That's D-Bag, everybody.
When did you even get here?
That's why I didn't dog. See what happened? I got kicked off YouTube.
Alright, for those of you who were just listening to it, this is D-Bag. Well, I'm not D-Bag, but we have D-Bag now on the channel. So D-Bag, why don't you introduce yourself to all of us?
Are you kidding? You just did.
I'm dying.
You don't want me to talk.
No, you really don't want him to.
No, if you're recording, you don't. Okay.
Alright, moving right along. So what is next?
We're gonna go up the lighthouse.
And yeah. The reason why they call it the lighthouse.
And this is why... Well, not this is why, but this is where the two pirates live. Is that correct?
Correct. And when we go to grab those, we're gonna pull them out and we're gonna attack the female first.
Yeah, I've been in this instance, but never went past those two because we've always had really hard time figuring out how to. Efficiently, I guess it's because, you know, the previous party I was in, it was a bunch of level 30 guys, and we all just get really swamped when the two came together.
In other words, it was a failed squad.
Right,
just
right.
Run through.
Fail, epic fail.
We're gonna run right up there past those mobs right into the elevator.
So are they gonna come up?
No, the mobs won't follow you upstairs, so you just run through.
Nice.
Less Tsunami, problem. I think your pet died.
He's still alive. He's fighting the mob down there.
If the guy boss comes, I'll tank him.
Is D-Bag still with us?
Yes, I think
ma'am.
So.
Nice. Finally, he's gone.
That guy's an asshole. You can say ass, right?
You're from Canada, so it's okay.
No, I see YouTube videos all the time.
Oh wow, what kind of canyon do you have there, dude?
Yes.
Is that like a little wolf mounted to a canyon gun or something?
Who are you talking to?
Tsunami man.
Oh, what was that?
Your gun looks like a wolf mounted onto it.
It's a skunk.
Oh, nice.
It's a cracking my specter of skunk.
Is that the reason why your character's wearing a gas mask?
Me? No, I'm not wearing a gas mask.
No, Tsunami.
Oh, okay.
From my angle, it looks like he's wearing a gas mask.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Oh, no. I guess that's his beard.
Yeah, it kind of looked like some sort of an oxygen tank.
Tsunami, go get the chick.
Yeah.
Alright, so which one should I attack?
The girl.
Marine girl.
Somebody pick up that water belt for me.
Can you move, please?
Thank you. Oh, hold on a minute. I've got to do something with my inventory.
Alright, filming on. Okay, so I think, how many bosses do we got left?
Just one.
One.
Are we gonna do the bonus crab boss?
Yeah, we'll kill him at the end.
On this next one here, I'm gonna take the ads.
Okay. I'm gonna auto with it.
What's that?
Oh wow, that thing is ugly.
Oh yeah.
It's got the hands of a crab ragoon. Oh wow, shoots.
Straightforward boss.
It shoots bullets out of its stomach, man.
It sort of reminds us something from like Pirates of the Caribbean.
Rip off.
This one's pretty straightforward though. There's just a couple ads that pop with them.
It looks like a pirate to me, not something from Pirates of the Caribbean.
D-Bag's name shall henceforth be known as the name that
You realize you can just click party chat and you'll only see party chat, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna try to
gotta
do
throw
that.
The guy on.
I'm gonna do that now. Yeah, but D-Bag shall henceforth be known as the guy whose name shall not be mentioned.
D-Bag?
Yes. The guy...
D-Bag?
Okay. So we're not going to mention D-Bag at all.
Don't even say D-Bag.
Okay, so we're done.
But we're going to jump down and go to the bonus bubble crab.
I'm calling dibs in the soul.
If you can get it first.
I want it first.
Give it to me first.
Get off my Lotus.
Too late.
Now I got dibs and boss. The soul, at least.
Where is this boss?
Right around the corner.
I'll pull it.
I don't see it.
I'm pulling it.
It's coming out.
I'm still pulling it. Some bubble crowd's supposed to be 5 years or something.
So does your channel like a G rating on it or whatever?
Yeah, but it's automatically censored, so like even if you swear, it doesn't matter.
So this here is going to give you a chance at a petzl steroids.
What's that?
This mob right here is going to give a petzl off. You can capture the soul.
Okay. How do I do that?
You have a soul capture skill.
Oh, I do.
So when you click it, if you can get to it before any of us do, you'll just push capture and you'll get it. And that's a way to make gold in the game.
Oh crap, slow down, I'm looking for that skill.
We're not DPSing right now.
Okay, I see it. Did I get it?
Who got it? Because I didn't even click on it.
How about that? Got it.
Who got it?
Is he gray?
He can link
it. Yeah, it's gray.
Darn.
There's my spoils.
And if you just hang on right here 1 second. Typically, after instances.
You kill your party.
I do this.
It's like the mint after your meal.
That's like the you flavoring.
Get at a Chinese restaurant.
Yeah. But considering up against the levels that were in there.
your way, name, you don't lose anything.
Alright, guys.
I accidentally targeted a crab.
Good job, Ice.
So, is that it?
Thank you.
That is the end of the instance.
That is the end of the instance. We're done.
Nice. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching our guild hunt here. What is this guild called? Not guild instance. Lost Lighthouse. So anyways, guys, if you're on the PvP East server, come check us out. Obscene level 4 guild. Send a message to any of the names you see here in the video, and we'll sure to give you an invite. And also, please do rate, comment, and subscribe to my channel. That really helps it out. And I'm also doing free giveaways on my channel, so be sure to check out my other videos. And until next time, I'll see you here at tomzan.us. Thanks.